You have something called a brittle bone mm-hmm. disease. What is that?
Well, it's called osteogenesis imperfecta, uh-huh. and it's the bones when you're born. It's a genetically inherited disease, and your bones, the wall is much thinner than it's like almost like eggshell.
Really?
Yeah, and there's different levels of the disease, and the whites of your eyes are blue. If you look at your uh-huh. eyes, they have a blue tint to them. That's a sign uh-huh. of having the disease, and you know.
It hasn't stopped you though. I mean, yeah, well, when I saw you playing, you were smacking the drums very hard.
Well, I'm pretty much. I rode ATC three-wheel motorcycles. And I'm pretty wild, so you know, I don't let the disease get in the way of playing.
Yeah, obviously. I read. Yeah, someone said that you broke like over 100 bones.
Oh yeah, easily. Maybe closer to 200. You know, so we lost count. You know,
yeah, but I mean, you've been in so many bands. That's obviously it's not a deterrent.
No. That will never get in the way of,
that's excellent.
Of anything I'm trying to do. And you know, so
yeah. Now I know you talked about Bonham.
Yeah.
And then you were. I know you had a couple kind of like Led Zeppelin. Type bands that you were, didn't, what was one of them? I can't remember what it was called.
Well, there was Hammer of the Gods, and then Get the Lead Out was a spinoff uh-huh. of Hammer of the Gods, my own. I put that together, so.
The Hammer?
No, that was, I joined up with this guy, and uh-huh. we just did that, and, you know, that was a tribute to Zeppelin, and, you know, things just didn't work out, a difference of opinion, and
yeah.
so, you know how that goes.
Right, but you guys were playing, like, all the Zeppelin tunes and,
yeah.
and touring or gigging, whatever.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Going around mostly Orange County area, mm-hmm. so you know, that was a pretty big thing over there, and you know, that's I just want to go other directions because
yeah.
that's kind of, you know, and you're back against the wall.
Yeah, but you were covering all the Zep tunes. You were trying to cover all the Bonham licks.
Yeah,
and stuff.
I could play like, you know, some of the hard, like In My Time of Dying.
And, yeah, it's
you know, quite hard.
So. Yes, it is.
Kind of makes life a thrill. I don't think that's right. I really been the best, the best of fools. You know, I did what I could. Cause I love you, baby. How I love you, darling. How I love you. How I love you.
Seem like there's
no, I've never really hung out with disabled people, so you know, it's kind of strange, and it's like I'm different and everything, and I'm disabled, but
yeah.
you know,
it doesn't stop you.
Yeah, I don't let that, it's like I try not to let that be, like you said, you know, something to get in the way.
Yeah, it's not, obviously. Mm-hmm. You know, you mentioned that too, not in the way you're talking about, like with your playing.
Mm-hmm.
I said something where you drop the double kicks and the licks,
yeah,
or whatever,
yeah.
the tricks. Are you more into playing time, or you know, just holding it down, kind of a meat and potato type thing, or?
Well, it's like I started experimenting with double kick, and then
uh-huh.
that got to be really kind of difficult for me. So I thought, well, you know, I've got all these drums, and it's like, how often do I use them?
Mm-hmm.
So I went back to the five.
You had a real big kit before?
I had like a 14-piece. plexiglass.
Oh yeah, Ludwig. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the big one. Yeah, so now you're into a smaller set.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you know, it's interesting. I guess the question I have for you is, for the viewers, is, you know, since it hasn't really gotten away, what do you think about? What do you do that motivates you? Because, I mean, like, I see your face here and there and already heard about you. I mean, what could you say to somebody who maybe was disabled who wanted to play drums?
Well, first of all, you got to believe in yourself. I mean, that's like, you know, people will tell you, you can't do this, you can't do that, and that's just a lot of baloney, you know, you can't go on that. You have to really, you have to believe, hey, I'm going to do this and nothing's going to get in the way, and, you know, things will happen for you if you have that frame of mind. And, you know, that's like, I've managed myself, I've done all my own promoting.
Oh, yeah.
And it's like, in the last 2 months, I've really done a lot, so, you know, I feel that for them, it's like they should mainly have a positive outlook on themselves. And, you know, if they feel like they want to do something, try it. And if it doesn't work, at least they tried, you know?
Yeah, well, see, I always feel that anybody, in my opinion, anybody can play drums.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, older people, obviously, you know, more female drummers, little kids. Wouldn't you tell me that you knew a drummer that I guess he plays in a wheelchair?
He has no legs.
No legs?
Yeah, he's...
How does he play the kick drums?
He's got a device that hooks up to his leg, and it connects... It's almost like a double bass kick thing, and it connects to his pedal so he can play. So,
is something like Rick Allen has, or...?
No, he plays a full acoustic set, so it's like... He plays an actual DW pedal, I think, and he uses the thing that... It's like a rod that connects to the pedal. And it's, you know, it's unbelievable to watch the guy, you know, he's like really amazing. So, you know, he's out of Orange County as well, so.
You know him?
Yeah. So he's like, there's not too many drummers, but, you know, they're out there.
You mean disabled drummers?
Yeah, too many disabled drummers, but,
yeah. You know. What kind of reaction do you get when, like, you sit down the kit and you start playing strong? I mean, what is like usually, is it, do band members get blown away or the audience?
Well, to be honest with you, it's like, this is the whole thing, this is where the problem comes in. Like, when I tell somebody that I play, actually at first they just go, yeah, you know, like they don't believe you.
Right.
But when they come and they see you playing,
yeah,
it's like they just go, wow, you know, they really freak out because, you know, they don't know how to react to it, whether or not, they should go, well, you know, it's really great, or what, you know, it's like they're kind of like, you know, just amazed.
Yeah, so. Well, when I saw the video of you, I was amazed. I was like, there's a drummer, there's, you know, and I could hardly even see you, but there, you know, there you were. Well, listen, Kurt, thank you for being here very much.
Yeah, appreciate it, and thanks for having me on.
Yes.
Hope to see you soon.
Yes, and also remember, always, stay by the beat.